Oh, hey there. Today is going to be a very good day because we are installing a mod on the Dodge Challenger, which I've been waiting to do for literally like the longest time. What's up, guys? What's going on? Welcome to the channel. Welcome back to the vlog. If you're new here, my name is Jeffrey. I do videos on my 2017 Dodge Challenger RT alongside the project vehicle on the channel, which is the 2005 lifted Jeep Grand Cherokee. But yeah, right now we're going to be working on the Dodge Challenger, and what we're doing today is doing the SRT grille swap out. And yeah, I've been waiting to do this for like a long time just because I don't really like the way that the normal RT front grille looks. But let me show you guys the SRT grille. So yeah, pretty much the SRT grille is just blacked out completely. Now the one thing I am going to be doing, that's going to be removing these SRT little badge plate, because I don't want to up badge my car. My car is a normal RT, it has the 5.7 engine, not the 6.4, and it's not, yeah, it's not an SRT, it's not a scat pack, it's just a normal 5.7, but I just like the way that the blacked out grille looks. And the one thing I do want to mention is, I don't really think it's up badging, just because now, with like the new 19s and stuff like that, 19s and 20s, I believe, you can get the normal GTs, which are the V6 all-wheel drive versions, and I think like even like the normal SXTs, they come with the SRT hoods, which I don't think that's really fair. That kind of sucks, because people from like the previous generations with the Chargers and Challengers, like your RTs, they don't look as cool as now the, you know, the V6s. So I don't really think that's up badging my car if I put in the blacked out grille and I take out the SRT badging. I'm gonna probably put the RT badging just still on it, but I just wanna have the blacked out grille. So I do wanna mention that. I'm not up badging my car. I just wanna make it look a little bit different. I think it'll look cooler. But yeah, without further ado, let's jump right into this thing. I think this process should take some time. So I tried to make sure I have enough time to do this. I have no idea how long it's gonna be. But yeah, without further ado, let's jump right into this thing, because hopefully this is gonna make this front end look so much better. It's a little bit cold out today, but we'll make it work. All right, let's do it. Walking away. She's walking away. She didn't want to stay out here with me. It's okay. Oh, it's okay. I'll be out here by myself. I had to pull the car completely out of the garage just to get that last bolt that's inside of the fender right there. It's like so hard to get, so I had to like pull the car out, stick my hand all the way in it. So that was really hard. Now you could do it with it still on the floor, you just have to turn the wheels completely in one direction when you go to each side. So I got that side done. Hopefully this side won't take me as long, but yeah, that was a pain to do. Let's do the other side real quick. Yes.
Okay, guys, that came off a little faster than I wanted it to come off. I think I'm going to take the bumper inside the house and then swap out the grill in the warmth, just because it's really cold out right now. And then I'm going to put the grill on tomorrow, just because it's really cold. My fingers are getting cold. It's like not even that late, but it's just cold outside, and I don't really want to fight with this thing anymore. So, yeah, that's what I'm going to do. But it looks kind of weird. So funny without the grill on. But yeah, let's take this in the house and let's keep working.
All right, guys, I just wanted to show you.
This is the grill. The front bumper. Brought the whole thing in here. This thing's actually a little bit heavier than what you would think, but it comes off completely. This brought upstairs. The one thing you have to worry about is that the electrical that's still attached. So that's the one. Good thing is, yeah, I guess it's only on one side. I thought it would be on both, but it's not. It's just connecting the fog light, so it just goes into the one side. It's connected to both right there. Now that I have this off, I'm gonna start the process of removing this front grill, this whole thing, and putting in the new one.
So yeah, I guess the bottom section that is attached to the underpan tray, so there's 7 of them. Actually, no, there's 9. All the other reviews I saw online said that there's only 7, but that's not true. There's 1, 2, and there's 5. And then there's 2. 1, and then 2.
And then, yep, that's the screw. The one that's super hard to take off, which I had to literally use a plier to kind of stick it in and just barely touch it and then screw it. Like unscrew it, then I had to reach my hand in the fender well, and then like unscrew it with my hand. So yeah, it's really being held on those 9 screws at the bottom. One clip here, and then there's the one that's been clipped. I believe it's right there. Same thing for the other side, and then the screws on the top. These like push pin things. So it's kind of a process to do, but you can do it. It takes a little bit of some time. If I could do it, and I'm not even like crazy or anything like that, I can, you know, if I could do it, I feel like don't be intimidated by it. You guys could definitely do it. And especially because I did it in the freezing cold. It's like 40 degrees, like 38. But yeah, so we're gonna continue with this process. Brand new day. All right, guys, so this is day 2 of this install. Hopefully we can get this done relatively quickly. I'm gonna swapping out the grill. All right, so as you can see, this is the back of the grill. To my knowledge, I believe, yeah, you're gonna have to unclip these. I think they just kind of unpop somehow. I'm gonna figure this out, how this pops off. I think you just have to like push this in and somehow all that pops off. The top portion pops off and should just pop in, honestly. Something like that. Now, I do know this grill is a little bit more straighter than this one, I believe. So, what I saw someone else did, they got some Gorilla tape to help kind of like, once you put it on, kind of like mesh it on, or just help support it with some Gorilla tape. So, we'll see how this goes. Hopefully, this should be a quick and easy process. This is the old grill, not grill, the old emblem. I believe I could just take this off. I'm gonna attempt to. I'm not sure if I can or not, but I'm gonna take this off, swap it out with this one. Yeah, it looks like this should. We'll see if this will fit. We will find a way. I'll find a way, and yeah, we'll get this done. But let's do it. All right, taking this off was a lot harder than what I thought it was gonna be. I had to like fight to get these off of these clips. I had to use a knife and a flathead just to get that off. But it came off. My God. Oh, I'm gonna turn this around real quick. All right, guys, so don't know how pretty this is gonna look from the backside, but as you can see, I had to trim off the bottom pieces, like these like little clips. It doesn't exactly line up. So I trimmed off the bottom pieces and I used Gorilla tape just to kind of make sure it stays flush with it. And then the top pieces I was able to mostly clip in, but I used some more Gorilla tape to kind of just keep it sealed tight. Because once again, this grill is much more straighter than the stock RT grill. This grill, as you see, has more of a bend to it. This one's a little bit straighter, so to make it fit up flush, you gotta kind of push it up against it. And I use some extra just adhesive Gorilla tape to make sure the back end stays as flush, you know, as possible. So let's turn this around. Let me see what it looks like. Overall, it looks pretty good. The RT badge, I had to put that back on. That was a little hard to take off. The mounting points are a little bit different, but I was able to make it work. So this whole process is, you know, you do have to do some trimming, some modifications, stuff like that. But I think it looks okay. So this is the SRT badge. Took that back off, put that on. I think overall, though, it looks a lot better.
That took a lot. Alright guys, I'm gonna end the video here, but I want to let you guys know how difficult I think this was and was it worth it. So on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being, you know, something super simple, and like 10 being like, I don't know, really, really difficult that you need to be a professional, this is 4 or 5. It's not like it's really super difficult. The one thing I do want to mention is that you do have to do some custom modifications to making the grill fit. Yeah guys, so it took me a minute, but I think it was worth it. I think it looks good. I can't wait to just like get the car washed. I'm like running super low on gas. I'm gonna get some gas, get the car washed, and just, I don't know, enjoy it. I love it the way it looks for right now. But yeah guys, I'm trying to do as much car content as I possibly can, because I know it's winter is coming. Like literally like a week ago, I had the car inside the garage for like literally like a week and a half because it started to snow. And yeah, when it snows, I'm not gonna be doing as much car content. I'm gonna be doing much more Jeep content. But you know, so I'm trying to get as much car stuff in as I possibly can before the winter comes. But I don't know, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, because in the next video, we're gonna be doing some stuff on the Jeep, which I honestly might start filming that video literally after I end this video. But yeah, so like that, I'm gonna interview here. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you like this video, and give it a like and check out my channel, follow me on Instagram, OmegaGreed, the same name as the YouTube channel. Go to the website, geeksofcars.com, and yeah, like that, we're out of here. See ya. Oh guys, if you made it to the very end of this video, let me know. I want to know if I start selling some like merch, just like some real quick decals, would you guys be interested? I don't know. Let me know. I might start selling it on my website, but let me know if you guys are interested in it at all. That'd be cool. All right. Goodbye.